Hey guys, Derek Z, physical therapist here. Welcome back to another video. In today's video, I'll be talking about shoulder pain as a result of shoulder impingement and exercises to help with that pain. Shoulder pain is something that I commonly see in the clinic, and shoulder impingement can happen for multiple reasons. And one of the contributing factors is muscular imbalances or other structures in the body resulting in either being it too tight or too weak. This can disrupt the scapulohumeral rhythm in your shoulder. And that is basically a kinetic interaction between your shoulder blade, which is the scapula, and your humerus, which is essentially your upper arm bone. The junction of these bones make up the ball and the socket joint, which is part of your shoulder. The scapular muscles and the rotator cuff is what's responsible for movement of the shoulder. So over here, I have a right shoulder joint. So here is the scapula, the humerus is here, and the clavicle is here. The rotator cuff originates off of the scapula, so you have four of them. So over on the front, you have what's called the subscapularis. The meaty part of the muscle is right over here, and it comes through, attaches onto the front of the humerus. On the back there, you have three rotator cuffs. Starting at the top, you have what's called the supraspinatus. The meaty part of the muscle is right over here in this fossa. It becomes a tendon, goes through this tiny little space called the subacromial space, which is where the impingement occurs for shoulder impingement, resulting in pain, comes through and it attaches over on the side of the humerus here. And then you have the infraspinatus, which then comes here and then attaches onto the back of the humerus here. And then lastly, you have the teres minor. The teres minor is a muscle that lives right underneath the infraspinatus, and it comes through, becomes a tendon, and attaches onto the back of the humerus here as well. So when your arm has to move up into the overhead position, out here like this, or when you want to throw a ball, the shoulder blade has to upwardly rotate, meaning it has to do this to provide a good space or a position for the head of the humerus. When it rotates up, it comes up this way. So that way, the integrity of this space is maintained, and it would not impinge. However, when there's dysfunction, either in the scapular muscles or in the rotator cuff, or if there's sometimes a little bit of arthritis in this area, which is also very common, either way, compromising that subacromial space, pinching will occur, which then is what we call impingement. So when your shoulder rotates up, either not fast enough, or your humerus brings your arm up too fast, either way, it's going to result in this, and that can essentially cause a rotator cuff tear, which then results in a surgical procedure, what's called a rotator cuff repair. So one of the approaches to treating shoulder impingement is, one, you can address the muscles of the scapula so it can upwardly rotate better, which then provides a better space for the humerus to move, or two, strengthen the rotator cuff, which then stabilizes the ball of the humerus in the center of the socket, which then also decreases the risk of the tendons impinging, or you address both of them together. So I will show you some exercises that essentially will strengthen the scapular muscles and the rotator cuff with minimal pain and minimal impingement of the shoulder. The research article that I cited these exercises from, which then I will link in the description below, they set the parameters for the subjects to perform these exercises for 3 sets of 15 for 4 weeks. After 4 weeks, they noted strength gains in the muscles of the shoulder at 8 to 10%. With that said though, if you can't do 3 sets of 15, that's not the end of the world. If you ask me though, 3 sets of 15, that's 45 repetitions. That's actually quite a lot. So if you did only 10, that's okay. That's only what your shoulder allows you to do. I would rather have you do 10 quality repetitions than 20 crappy ones with poor form. The other thing that the research article did not provide was the parameters in terms of how many times did the participants perform the exercises per week. I usually tell my patients 2 to 3 times a week to do these exercises at a minimum, especially if you are using weights. If you're not using weights and you're just lifting your arm, I think at a minimum of at least once a day should be adequate. At the end of the day, in terms of the parameters, you gotta listen to your body. If you feel like the exercise is too difficult to do, then definitely lower the weight or don't use any dumbbells. Just lift the weight of your arm. Some of these exercises, just the weight of your arm is enough, and that in itself is difficult to do. So when you're doing these exercises and you find that it's very hard or difficult for you to do, then definitely don't increase the weight. In fact, take the weight away, so then that way you can perform the exercise with better form. Sometimes the weight of the arm is enough for the muscles of the shoulder. So now we're going to jump into four exercises that are fundamental to do for shoulder impingement.
The first exercise here, it's called side lying external rotation. So what you want to do first is take a spacer like a towel and put it in between your arm and your trunk and just rest your arm on top of it. This puts the shoulder in a good position so the rotator cuff can engage in the optimal way. When you got this down, what you want to do, the other thing, is not use weights that are too heavy. Over here, I'm only using a 2 pound, but I'm performing high repetitions. In the literature, they're recommending 3 sets of 15 with the exertion of about 40% when you're doing this, particularly because these muscles are small. When you are putting too much effort, you will recruit other muscles around your shoulder, which then leads down to compensations. Exercise number 2, it's called prone shoulder extension. With this exercise, what you're going to do is lay on your stomach, and then with both your arms, you're going to point your thumbs outward, and you're going to raise your arms straight back into extension towards your hip, and you're going to slowly lower your arms, and then you're going to repeat from there on out. What you want to focus on here with this is also on your shoulder blades. You don't want to shrug your shoulders. You don't want your shoulders to go towards your ears. When you're doing this, you want to squeeze your shoulder blade and bring your arm into extension. When you're squeezing your shoulder blade into retraction, what you're actually doing is maintaining the integrity of that subacromial space. So it puts the shoulder blade in a healthier position. I also understand that most of you may not have a table with a face hold, so another way to do this while you're laying on your stomach is to take a towel, roll it up, and put it over your forehead, so then that way you have some breathing room. The next one is called prone tease. With this move, it's basically a progression from the previous one. When you do this, again, you're laying on your stomach just like the previous exercise. You're gonna go ahead and have both arms out to your side. And then when you do this, make sure you point your thumbs up towards the ceiling when you're raising your arm. This exercise enhances the scapular position and also maintains the integrity of that subacromial space, thus leading to a lower likelihood of impingement when you're performing this move. Last exercise here is going to be prone rows 90-90. The starting position again is going to be on your stomach. What you're going to do is you're going to bring your shoulders and your elbows out to the side, and then you're going to retract your shoulder blade up, and then from there you're going to move your shoulders up into what's called external rotation. Hold it there for a couple seconds, and then you're going to slowly lower to the starting position, and then you're going to repeat from there on out. This exercise has a lot of activity in the infraspinatus and the teres minor, which is the rotator cuffs that I mentioned earlier.
If your shoulder feels sore after performing these exercises, feel free to use some ice and apply it to the sore region for about 10 to 20 minutes. I hope you find these exercises helpful. If you have any questions, please leave in the comments section below. If you enjoy this content, please consider liking and subscribing. I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.